Australia Day 1972 saw the first Aboriginal embassy erected outside Parliament.
The native title legislation must be amended.
They've walked this land so many times before anybody...
Australia, I am sorry.
Today on Living Black, the push to acknowledge Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islanders in the Australian Constitution.
To come closer together, to build respect, to build unity, to build ways of understanding.
Alcohol restrictions under the Northern Territory intervention. Has it made a difference?
Unfortunately, all the intervention tended to do was to prohibit where people can drink. Did nothing to reduce supply.
And the Living Black Music Project continues. This week we feature Young Nookie, a rapper from the New South Wales South Coast. Hello and welcome to Living Black. I'm Carla Grant. For the last 5 months, an expert panel has been asking Australians their views about changing the constitution to recognise Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people. A group of high school students from New South Wales have done their own consultations, following in the path of activist Charles Perkins' famous 1965 Freedom Rides. Dan Conifer has more.
This is not your typical consultation. There are no bureaucrats and there's no note-taking. Following the path of the original Freedom Ride, these high school students from the central coast of New South Wales have visited Aboriginal communities across the state. They asked how Indigenous Australians should be recognised in the Constitution. Now they're delivering their message book to the people designing the changes.
They'll see that there's so much support behind it from all the different communities, because with us is the book, and the book's got all the support and messages from everybody else.
The federal government has promised to hold a referendum on acknowledging Indigenous Australians in the Constitution.
We're calling on Australians to come forward with their suggestions.
It appointed a 22-member expert panel to ask community members what form recognition should take. Panel member Janelle Saffin says all the messages are being heard.
As I was sitting there listening to them, I thought, that's a really good thing. 21 more communities that have been consulted by them, and we've got their messages directly.
The panel will report back to the federal government by the end of the year. So far, they've received a diverse range of views.
It could be something like the apology in terms of a statement of recognition of the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Island peoples. That gives puts beyond doubt that they were the original peoples of this country.
Points of view the expert panel is trying to work through.
Behind me is the room where the panel's meeting, and I've been lucky enough to steal this book from them, the book that the 2011 Freedom Riders presented to them. Now in it is full of submissions and ideas for how to change the Constitution. The panel now has to take this and the rest of their ideas and come up with a question, the one they're going to put to the Australian people.
Many panel members feel that constitutional change alone won't improve Indigenous lives unless it's backed up by appropriate policies.
People talk about symbolic and practical, and I say symbolism is important in all communities. It's important in Australian life. There's things we do every day that are symbolic. And I say the debate around that is, you know, it's sort of, is it symbolic or is it practical? And they're both important, and we have to work on both at all times.
And there's also discussion about removing discriminatory aspects of the Constitution, which say that states can disqualify people from voting and that laws can be made on the basis of race. This happened with the Northern Territory intervention, which suspended the Racial Discrimination Act to control welfare payments to Aboriginal people. Law Professor George Williams says these parts of the Constitution must go.
Well, my view is if we don't remove the discriminatory sections, I don't think the referendum will get up. I don't think people will see it's good enough to have fine words at the beginning of the document that recognise Aboriginal people, but at the same time retain the possibility of discriminating against them on the basis of their race.
For change to occur, most Australians and a majority of the states will have to vote yes at the referendum. Only 8 of 44 referenda have been passed, so historically a no vote is a real possibility.
But it'd be a very serious setback to us as Australians in terms of our reconciliation intentions and the good work that many Australians have been doing over a long period of time now to come closer together, to build respect, to build unity, to build ways of understanding.
But with the backing of both major political parties, many are confident that constitutional change will happen. And for these teenagers, that would mean they've been a part of another freedom ride which has helped create change for Indigenous Australians.
The opportunity for public submissions on constitutional change closes at the end of this month. For more information, go to www.umeunity.org.au. Still to come on Living Black, Palm Island struggles with health and education problems, but local children receive some help and inspiration from Kathy Freeman.